everyone, my name is Soodabeh and I am an Iranian illustrator and designer. Thanks for tuning in. First of all, happy holidays. I really hope this season is filled with fun, family, and joy. I thought this would be a great time to learn how to draw a Christmas tree with some fun decorations. I already prepped my sketch. I used Procreate for that, and I'm going to import it into a fresh canvas by tapping on this plus sign. I then resize and reposition it until I like the way it looks. Now it's time for the vector art. After I lower the opacity of my sketch layer, I create a new one where I start drawing. Let's pick up my first color, which is this beautiful yellow. Having a color palette ready is going to help a lot as you create your artwork. I usually like to start with the background. It's just my personal process, but you can start however you want. With the pen tool selected, I'm tapping and dragging until the shape matches my sketch underneath. The pen tool definitely requires practice, but once you give it a proper try, you will learn how to do it intuitively. And of course, it does not have to be perfect, because if you are working with vectors, you can simply readjust your paths with the node tool. Watch my video on how to create great compositions if you'd like to understand how to draw illustrations that look balanced from a structure but also chromatic perspective. Speaking of which, I changed the color of the second background shape to a light orange. For the smaller circles, I prefer to use the shape tool. And then again, I'm giving these shapes different colors. Time for the focal point, which is the Christmas tree. Since the shape is so straightforward, I pick up the pen tool and I simply tap once in each corner. It's that easy. For the trunk, I've decided to switch to the shape tool, and once I've created the rectangle, I color it brown and move it behind the tree from the quick actions menu. I then create the ground with the shape tool. Change the color to dark blue and place it all the way to the back. With the brush tool, I'm drawing some leaves and part of the background. I like to add a few layers to my illustration by drawing these small details around the focal point. If you guys are familiar with my drawing style, then you are familiar with these elements. With the brush tool, you can draw just like you would on paper, so it's very easy to freehand these shapes. When I'm done drawing, I place them behind the tree. I then add some more dimension to my illustration by creating this baby shadow shape with the pen tool. But you can also use the pencil tool if you find it easier. I make sure I close my shape so I can apply a Boolean operation. Since I want my shadow to follow the shape of the tree, I duplicate the tree shape, place it in the back, select it together with the shadow, and finally I apply intersect. Next, I pick my trusty pen tool again and tap in each corner of the star shape to create the tree topper. I could also use the star tool, but I prefer to freehand this so it does not look too perfect. It's time to decorate our tree. I'm starting with the lights. I only need to draw one oval with the shape tool, because then I just duplicate and rotate them around so they match my sketch. Don't forget, you don't need to fill up your entire Christmas tree. Leave room for all your elements to breathe. Let's move on to the ornaments. And I've chosen a very classic color here, bright red. It may not look like it now because all my colors are at low opacity, which allows me to still see my sketch. But it will look super bright in a minute. As I was adding these details, I realized that I need to change the color of my background shape to a darker tone. I think it's more balanced now. Last ornament is done. So I'm moving on to the line that holds the lights together, and I'm drawing that with a white brush stroke to add a bit of contrast. The bow is next. I'm creating it with the pen tool just because it's made of various smooth curves, and I'm giving it two colors, one for the inside of the fabric and one for the outside. Once the left side is done, I duplicate and flip it so I can create the other half in just a few seconds. I place the ribbon in the back and then I draw the middle by creating a circle with the shape tool. You may notice that I rarely create perfect circles. I just think it adds more character to my illustration when I create these shapes without holding one finger on the canvas. Okay, time to see what our colors really look like. Now they are so much brighter than before. Seeing the illustration like this helps me decide what adjustments I need to make, like any colors, shapes, or sizes that might need tweaking. I want to make the star shine, so I'll show you just how easy it is to do that. I duplicate my shape and apply a blur effect to it. That's it. For the final details, I will be focusing on the ornaments as they look very simple at the moment. First of all, let me move them on top of all other layers. The multi-select tool is super useful here. With the shape tool, I decorate my gloves with a very simple pattern. Then with the brush tool, I'm adding two horizontal lines which I mask behind the globe shape. To keep things interesting, I'm making different designs for different globes using the brush tool. Simple yet very effective. Since this particular globe is directly under the shining star, I've decided to give it a highlight for either light or shadows. I create a curve shape with the pen tool and then I apply intersect. I've also lowered the opacity to about 30% and added a couple more white brush strokes for that extra shine. The globes are missing their caps. A simple yellow rectangle is all it takes. And don't forget the hooks which hold them onto the branch. As usual, I'm duplicating, placing, and resizing my original shape to fit all the other ornaments. I decided to add another layer to the background since I think the black yellow color is a bit too overpowering. So I'm dividing it with a wave looking shape created with the pen tool and then I apply intersect, just like before. As a very last step, I'm creating a shadow for the tree trunk. And with that, we finished our Christmas tree illustration. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you were able to follow along. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you next year. Happy holidays, everyone!